Hey guys, what's up? It's Julia, and today we are going to be working on Unit 12, Statistics. This is Day 1, which is Confidence Intervals for Population Proportion, P. Let's get down to it. So I want you guys to read this little snippet of a paragraph. So you have 1,029 total U.S. adults, and 494 people reported they are often or always get enough sleep during the last 7 nights. Calculate the following. So for PHAT, we're just going to take the number of people who have reported that they often or always had enough sleep, and we're going to put that over the total of 1,029 adults. And we can put this into decimal form if you want. 494, yep, it says round to the nearest hundredth, so we're gonna just divide that. And we were given 0.48. Next, we're gonna construct a 95% confidence interval for the proportion of all Americans who would report that they often or always got enough sleep during the last 7 nights. So go to your Transpire, select menu, sorry for the glare, guys. And then go to stats, 6, and then go to 6 confidence intervals. Then you're gonna select 5, 1 prop C interval. And the successes, we're gonna use that as our 494. Oh. Over our total, which is N number, 1029. And we're always gonna have it at 2 standard deviations because it said construct a 95% confidence interval. And you're gonna select okay. So you're given this amazing, beautiful list. And since it's asking for the interval, we're just gonna take the lower bound and the upper bound. And it says round to the nearest hundredth. So lower bound is 0.45 and the upper bound is 0.51. Yep, and now it says, next is find the margin of error, round to the nearest hundredth, okay. Always underline where you're gonna round to. And wonderfully enough, on the calculator, it gives us our margin of error, which is ME. So ME equals 0.03. Interpret the 95% confidence interval. Here, we're just going to say we are 95% confident that the true proportion of adults who often or always got enough sleep during the last 7 nights falls in the interval interval 0.45 and 0.51. All this interpretation is just some All it is asking you to say that you are 95% confident that the true proportion of adults who often or always get enough sleep, they fall within the interval, which is right here, 0.45 to 0.51. Just state 95% confident they fall into the interval. Now, part E, the last part. Label the following normal curve. Also find the standard deviation. Recall that 95% of the data falls within 2 standard deviations of the average. Okay, let's do it. So we know that 0.45 represents 2 standard deviations right up on here. So we're gonna just label that's gonna be 0.45. And 2 standard deviations over here, that's gonna be 0.51. Remember, go back to the interval that we just set. Okay, so this is gonna represent, we're gonna do some shading. That's 95%. Now we're going to take our p-hat value, because this is just everything deviating away from our p-hat value, which is 0.48. Now we need to figure out what our first standard deviation is, okay? Or just the regular standard deviation. So if we know that ME equals 0.03, our margin of error, the standard of deviation is going to equal the margin of error divided by 2. So 0.03 divided by 2 that's going to give us 0.015. So when you see this, you're just going to add 0.015. So 0.45 plus 0.015, that gives us on our first one 0.465. Right over here. And we're just going to do 0.51 plus 0.015. Minus. And we get 0.495. And we labeled this graph. Awesome.